Today I'm going to talk to you about something which is almost counterintuitive. And I have found at least that in my own life, there have been many moments where I thought about this very topic very differently. And as life went on, I suddenly realized that no, I'm thinking about this the wrong way. Most of you know me as the author of what is known as the Bharat series. And the Bharat series, of course, is a series of books within the space of history, mythology, theology, culture, religion. And the first book in that series was a book called The Rosabal Line. There was another book called Chanakya's Chant, The Krishna Key. A sixth book in this series is scheduled for January, this coming January, for the sixth book in this series to be released. And a second book called Private Delhi came out a couple of years after that. And then, of course, there are the 13 Steps books, which I write along with people who have a domain knowledge in those specific verticals. So 13 Steps to Bloody Good Luck was the only book in this series which was written entirely by me. Pursuant to that, there was a book called 13 Steps to Bloody Good Wealth, one on Marx, one on parenting, one on health, and of course, each of these books, during his lifetime, he sent me a little over 400 books. So I think I didn't know it at that time, but there was a writer which was brewing inside me. So let's come back to the world of business. Nanaji would send me this book. And of course, in the early days, I was not that interested in reading those books. I was more interested in actually collecting them because it felt very nice on the shelf. And the old man wisened up. He lived in Kanpur, is that I wasn't reading. So he said that, no, now we've changed the formula. I will send you a book every Monday or Tuesday. And by the next week, when my man comes to give you a second book, you will give me a book report on the first. So you will tell me what you read, what you liked, what you didn't like, why did you like it, why did you not like it. And so that was the earliest exposure, really, to writing. Now, I would always be so excited when each of these books came. I would go into my dad's place of work, into the office, and I would be holding whatever happened to be the latest book that Nanaji had sent. And in our office, there was a Munimji who wore a topi and a dhoti and a black coat with a kala topi. And Munimji would see me with this book. And, you know, I would still get through the work that was supposed to be got through. The only difference was lunch hour meant that I could snatch half an hour to actually read a few more pages. And Munimji used to get rather irritated by all of this. He would say that bookkeeping is more relevant than book reading. So if you really have to do something worthwhile in your life, then focus on bookkeeping, not on book reading. And he said, if you must read, then read a balance sheet. I'm there to teach you how to read a balance sheet. Why are you wasting your time doing all of this? So I would go back to Nanaji, and Nanaji had this wonderful way with words. And I would say, Nanaji, you know, this Munim is saying that I should not be focusing on those books that you send me. And Nanaji would say that, listen, Ashwin, you know, the problem with the rat race is that even if you win, you are still a rat. So he said, you have to decide whether you want to go through your life being a rat. And he would say that the only thing that money gives you is the freedom of not having to worry about it. Nothing more, nothing less. And then Nanaji had this wonderful little insight to offer. He would say that, listen, Lakshmi without Saraswati is of no use. Only when Lakshmi and Saraswati sit together can one prosper. And of course, in our Hindu pantheon of gods, there is this very interesting little tale about Lakshmi and Saraswati. that Lakshmi ji, even though she in her own ways is extremely powerful, but she tends to be a little curious and a little jealous of Saraswati. So if Saraswati happens to be in this room, then Lakshmi wants to be there. And in case Saraswati gets up to leave, then Lakshmi wants to get up and find out as to where has Saraswati gone. And the only deity in our Hindu lineup that we have who can sit between these two devis at the same time is Ganesh, which probably explains why Ashwin Sanghi looks the way he does. Because my entire focus has been getting the two devis to sit by my side. And here I am in a room full of devijis. So, in that sense, Ganesha is really the original connector. He is the connector of Lakshmi and Saraswati and the connector of wealth and knowledge. And so Nanaji would simply say to me, Beta, if you have to live your life like Ganesha. Be Ganesha. And so despite the fact that it was a business background, suddenly I realized one fine day, many, many years after having worked in a business environment, having earned an MBA in finance, having put in several years at a family outfit. So I called up a dear friend of mine, and some of you would have heard her name, Namita Devi Dayal. She's a cousin of mine, and by then she had already published her first book. And so I said, Namita, you have to help me. Samuel Johnson was once approached by a young writer, and the young writer said that, sir, would you do me the honor of reading my manuscript and telling me how it reads? And Samuel Johnson did not want the young man to be, sort of left in a lurch. And he said, even though I'm very busy, I will read the manuscript. And he read it, and a month later, he told the young man, he wrote him a little letter, and he said, your manuscript is good and original, but the part that's good isn't original, and the part that's original isn't good. My situation in life was a lot like this. I still remember one of the first reviewers in the US for the book, The Rosabal Line, said, Ashwin Sanghi has written a good book, but it could have been a little shorter. Maybe he should have stopped on page 10. 12 was the number of times that the first book in the Harry Potter series was rejected by publishers. 18 was the number of times that Jonathan Livingston Seagull was rejected. And 30 was the number of times the first book by Stephen King, Carrie, was rejected. And Chicken Soup for the Soul had 33 rejections.